what's in the bag? Oh, what's in the bag? Oh, oh no! Oh! Welcome back to another episode. Sorry for the short break, guys. I've had some technical difficulties. My computer I've got up and running again, so I'll be able to start producing again. This is just a quick video to get you guys back into the swing of things, get me back into the swing of things. And we're just gonna take a look at some DVDs that I picked up. So I went into a pawn shop. You'll see some of it in an upcoming thrift-in. But the guys proceeded to bring out multiple big boxes from the back of the store, all DVDs, to show me, and I sifted through them for a little over an hour, I think. I mean, I looked through at least 1,000 DVDs, and there were a bunch of cool things in there, hard to find, rare, some valuable, just things that I've never really seen, and I'm gonna show you guys what I got sort of behind that, in that behind the scenes sort of segment here today. So before we jump in, I'd love to know what you guys have been watching, since it's been a while since I've talked to you. I'd love to know what you guys have been watching, what you've picked up, anything like that. Feel free to leave that down in the comments below, and we'll try to get a little discussion rolling. I also have a Patreon and t-shirts. Links are in the description below. Feel free to check those out if you so please. Without any further ado, we're going to jump right in. No stand, no table today. We're just going to do it sitting on the floor, old school style. And in no particular order, we have Alien 3000. Your guess is as good as mine. When I first picked this up, when I first saw this, I was like, this, I thought it was Dracula 3000, because there's a film called Dracula 3000, which is terrible, but definitely a lot of fun to watch with friends. I think it's cool. Who's in? I forget who's in that. Alien 3000, however, has Lorenzo Lamas. So there's your Priscilla Barnes. Let's see if there are any other names we know. Jeff Leroy directed. Yeah, that's really... It's going to be a doozy. Look at that cover. Rip off anyone? Alien 3000. Hey, as long as I get some goofy monster creature feature fun, I'll be happy. The Tuskegee Airmen. This one's pretty cool to find. Lawrence Fishburne follows the Tuskegee Airmen, which were an all-black Air Force unit in the United States in World War II, I believe the first all-black unit. And this is the story of them, starring Lawrence Fishburne. This was an HBO release. Directed by Robert Markowitz, who I've not heard of. We have Alan Payne, Courtney B. Vance. I love Courtney B. Vance. John Lithgow, Cuba Gooding Jr. Very cool. I'm not sure when this was made. It has 2009 on it, but this is back in the 90s for sure when this was made. This is still sealed. Very cool to find this. Looking forward to getting some history and some entertainment there. Lucas Haas in The Cradle. Now, I like Lucas Haas. He pops up in a lot of things as a character actor, but in this, he's actually the lead role. And he plays a father. It's like a traditional ghost story. I don't know much about it. I read a little bit on Letterboxd, the little blurb there. But it's from 07, and I've never heard of The Cradle. And I'm looking to dig back into the aughts, since it was a decade where I was very intoxicated in my youth and going to high school. And I've been wanting to go back to the aughts and sort of dig into the horror of that decade, because I don't remember it being too great. It was kind of a dead era for cinema and for horror, I would say. But Cradle is one I want to check out from 07, so pretty cool there. Next up, we have a few of these After Dark Horror Fest ones, which I've never seen these in the wild. This is After Dark Horror Fest 4 from 2010. I have a few of these in sets and a few random movies out of the collections here and there. But here we have The Final, Kill Theory, and The Reeds. These always have great covers, always kind of pull you in. And the films are usually mediocre. Some are great, some are really bad, but most of them are mediocre, just right in the middle. No directors that I know or anything like that. Chris Moore and Nick Cohen I recognize, but I'm not exactly sure. But I'm excited to have picked up these three After Dark Horror Fest ones. I'm not sure how many there were from this year. There's usually like 7 or 8 or something like that. I wish these were a little bit more diverse and I wish these were a little diverse in terms of the countries they were made, but it seems that they're all at least North American. Anyway, I want to give those a shot. That's one of the things I like about the After Dark stuff. They always go to different countries, South Korean, Japan, you know, Taiwanese movies, all that kind of stuff, all horror. So, Duel at Diablo is one. James Garner and Sidney Poitier. Don't know much about this. From the 60s, so this is during the era of the spaghetti westerns, so this is probably a little little tougher, a little harsher, a little more violent, things like that. So America was trying to keep up with what the spaghetti westerns were doing. So I do want to check this out. I'm a big fan of Poitier. I like Garner as well. So yeah, we'll give this a shot. And directed by Ralph Nelson, who I definitely recognize the name. House Guest. I was so thrilled to find this. If you guys remember, I found this on VHS a few months ago now at the National Pawn. Found it on DVD. All of these were in perfect shape, except for this one, which had a few light scratches, but it'll play fine. This is Phil Hartman and Sinbad. This is right during the era, right smack dab in the middle of the era that I grew up in the 90s. I want to say like 95 or 96 this came out. Sinbad was on fire in the 90s. Everybody loved Sinbad. I still remember him fondly from Jingle All the Way, from movies like this, and another one you'll see coming up in a moment, which was amazing to see two Sinbad films. And Capital, all two Sinbad films. Capital is a film with Gabriel Byrne. I don't know much about this one. It seems to be a French film. And it's about, I read the quick blurb, it's about a bank, a banker, the lead of a CEO of a bank of some sort. He has a lot of power, and America is trying to buy this bank out. And it's about him trying to hold on, grasp at the final bits of power that he has, or try to control as much of the bank as he can without selling it. So that is Capital. Definitely going to be a political drama, but every once in a while I'm in the mood for those, especially as of late. The more political theory, more political history, and history that I read in general, I get more and more interested in films like these. So, very excited for that one. Chateau's Land. This is Charles Bronson and Jack Palance. What a cast. Directed by Michael Winner. That's good to see. This is obviously a Chuck Bronson Western, where he plays a Native American, it seems. So, he has the look. I mean, he definitely doesn't look like a white guy. It's clear that there's more in his DNA and his blood than just European. So I guess it kind of works for this. But music by Jerry Fielding, 1972. Looking forward to adding this to the Western collection. Here's a Stallone film that I did not have on the Stallone shelf over there. This is Paradise Alley. Man, I don't know much about this film, but on the back it looks like a Rocky movie, so... Like, there's a whole bunch of boxing and everything. Like, each one of the shots on the back is just boxing. So I wonder if they did that strategically, the marketing, so that people would buy it, thinking it's sort of like a Rocky film. That's probably what it is, but I'm sure boxing has something to do with the film, obviously. I'm not sure how big of a plot device it is, though. Who directed this? Let's see. Written and directed by Sly Stallone. I did not know that. Early Stallone, written, directed by... Is this pre-Rocky? It must be. It's post-Rocky. Okay, so a few years after Rocky in 78. Paradise Alley. Really looking forward to checking this out. I know it's going to be a good, classic-feeling New York film by Sly. Good director. By Dawn's Early Light. Now, this is a director that I am familiar with, I believe. If not... Yes, Jack Shoulder, who did The Hidden. And also Freddy's Dead... Nightmare on Elm Street 2, amongst many other films, Alone in the Dark, which I've talked about recently, from 1981 with Jack Palance and Martin Landau. Four people, 3 minutes, two choices, one chance for survival. Powers Booth, Rebecca De Mornay, James Earl Jones, Martin Landau, speak of the devil. We've also got Rip Torn, Darren McGavin, whew, Rebecca De Mornay, man, just such a cast here. And directed by Jack Shoulder, so that was all I needed. The cast plus the director that I really, really enjoy. I'm not sure exactly what By Dawn's Early Light is. I think it's some sort of disaster film or pre-disaster film where it's like the nuclear era and it's the Cold War and, you know, there's a threat of nuclear bombs dropping, etc. I think that's what this is, just judging by how it looks. But we'll give it a shot at some point. This is one of the cooler things I've found. I'm a big fan of mafia films, especially older ones. Mob movies from the 90s, 80s, and even in the early 2000s. Chaz Pelementary did a film called Boss of Bosses from 01, directed by Dwight Little, another director who did a bunch of action films in the 80s. I believe Dwight Little, it doesn't say Dwight H. Little, but I'm assuming it's the same Dwight Little. Might be different. But what did he do? I want to say Rapid Fire, if I'm not mistaken, with Brandon Lee. This is the true story of real-life godfather Paul Castellano, who was a big player in the Italian mob during the 60s and 70s. And yeah, this is going to be really cool. It's got your, you know, obligatory Italian-American cast. Let's see. Clancy Brown. No. Chaz Pilimentary. Sonny Marinelli. I don't know the names, but man, these guys look familiar, don't they? You've seen them in every mob movie ever. So that is Chaz Pilimentary in Boss of Bosses. This was so cool to find. Definitely an obscure, unknown little mob film with pretty much the guy that was... Chaz Pilimentary is made for the mob film, right? He's a great actor. Definitely does more than just mob movies, but we all know him for mob movies, no doubt. Including A Bronx Tale, one of the best. The Stoned Age. One of you guys recommended this to me. Because I think I had mentioned among, you know, all the video ideas that I mentioned that I was going to do a stoner comedy video. And somebody mentioned that this is one of the best, most underrated ones. Now, obviously, it looks like Dazed and Confused, even as compared to it on the front. It's got all the psychedelic sort of coloring going on, that kind of stuff. But I don't know much else about this. I know it's from 03. Well, it looks like it's from 03, directed by James Melkonian. Nobody that I really know on it. In fact, they don't even list people's names on the back, or on the front. So that's going to be, you know, that means there are a bunch of obscure actors here, which is not a bad thing. I love the cover. Looks like a fun movie. Coming of age, stoner, comedy, drama kind of thing. And the next Sinbad movie that I picked up here was First Kid. Now, I actually have really fond memories of this one. Houseguest I remember, but First Kid I remember even more. I just love the idea of this kid getting all this power. Sinbad was sort of the bodyguard. But this was a Disney film, and I really remember loving this. Again, mid-90s when Sinbad was on top of the world. Perfect condition. Really looking forward to checking this out. Again, it's going to be a nostalgic one. Now, this one, The Big Alligator River by Sergio Martino, is also known as The Great Alligator. I don't know much about this. I think it's about a killer alligator or a killer river. I don't know. Mel Ferrer and Barbara Bach in this one. Hey, it's an Italian horror kind of adventure action kind of thing, so I had to pick it up. This is released by No Shame Films, the Sergio Martino collection, which is a little bit of a weird release. I've never seen a No Shame Films release. 1979, awesome. Very cool to add to the collection. I'm assuming it's going to have some animal cruelty in it, which, you know me, I'm not going to be able to really watch it if that's the case. But I'll at least keep it in the collection for the Italian horror preservation in me. Preservationist. Windwalker. This is a film from 1980 with Trevor Howard, Nick Ramis, James Remar, and Billy Drago. Now, this follows a dying or an aging Native American shaman or chieftain of some sort, and it's got fantasy and adventure, and it's just about him recounting his lives, and it sounds beautiful. And from 1980, a Native American-centric film from 1980, I definitely want to give this a shot. It's got, like, the family classics and sterling release, so it's not going to be a great release here. Not expecting much from the quality, but... Hey, Roger Ebert apparently liked it. A magnificent movie, The Vision and Natural Beauty of Dances with Wolves. So that's great praise coming from one of the great critics of all time, for what it's worth. Another shoddy release here, but these Zorro films and old serials you don't see very often. I have a bunch of them. I am grateful to have a bunch of them. This is actually not that old. I thought it was older. This is from 1963, Guy Stockwell, Michaela Wood star in this legendary tale of Zorro and his fight for justice. Now, I'm not sure if this has better releases. It might not. I tried a quick search on eBay and couldn't find anything but this, and this was going for $20-$25. Perfect shape, Zorro movies, definitely interested in cracking into those at some point, and all the serials and stuff like that. Of course, I grew up with the Antonio Banderas one. Still enjoy that movie quite a bit, directed by Martin Campbell. Now, I'm a collector of the Christmas Carol, or A Christmas Carol movies. I've got a bunch, you know, Albert Finney, Scrooge, you've got Patrick Stewart, you've got George C. Scott, you've got Alistair Sim, got ones from the silent era, you've got countless, countless Christmas Carols. And I was happy to run into one that I had yet to add to the collection. Kelsey Grammer as Scrooge, as Ebenezer Scrooge. So let's see who directed this. Arthur Allen Seidelman? This apparently, I guess it was a TV movie. Jason Alexander, Jennifer Love Hewitt, Jane Krakowski. This looks like a period piece too, so it looks like it takes place during the Victorian era. You know, 1860s, something like that, circa 1860s. Hallmark Entertainment. But sometimes they have some really fun, wholesome movies that they put out in the 90s and early 2000s. This hopefully is one of them. I probably will be checking it out this year since this is one of the few Christmas carols that I've yet to see. I should say... There are a few. I haven't seen the Patrick Stewart. I haven't seen the Albert Finney. So there are still a few that I need to see. Another Sidney Poitier, Burt Lancaster, Richard Kiley, separate but equal, based on true events about the during the mid-50s, I think it was 55 or 56, the Supreme Court ruled that we would start desegregating schools. And this is the story of that time, starring the man, Sidney Poitier. This is directed by and written by George Stevens Jr. I don't recognize that name, or I recognize the name, but I don't know what else he's done. Burt Lancaster as well. Seems to be possibly a TV movie. Not exactly sure, but I'm excited to add this to the collection. This is another not too easy one to find. And we've got two left here. We've got Wild Bill. I was thrilled to find this. I thought I had it in the collection. This is one of the few Walter Hill films I've yet to see, or at least yet to add to the collection. Thrilled to have this. This has Jeff Bridges, Ellen Barkin, directed by Walter Hill, written by Walter Hill, of course, 2 hours, based on the life of Wild Bill Hickok, 1995 Western, in a time where Westerns were, you know, not too poppin'. There was a lot of deconstructing going on. It was sort of the death of the West, the American Western, in a lot of ways, with Unforgiven coming out. And Wild Bill, I've heard not great things about, but it's Walter Hill, man. I gotta give it a try. Glad to add this to the Walter Hill collection. And last, but hopefully not least, I don't think it will be, a Franco Zeffirelli film. John Voight, Faye Dunaway, and Ricky Schroeder in The Champ. This is a boxing movie. I like me a good boxing movie. There's something about a boxing movie that, I don't know, it's a good distillation of life in itself, boxing. You know, getting the courage to get up into the ring, fight your heart out, no matter if you win or lose, you still did it. It's a big metaphor for life, and that's why boxing movies work so well in cinema. That's why there are so many in cinema. It's a one-on-one fight to win, you know, and it could symbolize life in many ways, and thus it does, I think. And that's why Rocky's so popular and so many other great boxing films out there. This is The Champ with John Voight here, a young, spry-looking John Voight in great shape, directed by Franco Zeffirelli, who also did Jesus of Nazareth, I believe. And this is from 1979, and I'm looking forward to checking this out. I have never even heard of this, to be quite honest with you, so very happy to add this to the collection. It's got a little dirt on the front I gotta get off, but otherwise in perfect shape. Pretty cool. That's gonna do it for this stack of not too easy to find DVDs, guys. I hope you enjoyed this little video. If you did, feel free to give it a thumbs up, and if you're new to the channel and want to see more videos like it, go ahead and hit the subscribe button as well as the little bell for notifications. I also have a Patreon and t-shirts. Links are in the description below. And I'd love to know what you guys have picked up over the last couple weeks, couple months. It's been a few weeks since I've talked to you, since my computer's been down, and I'm gonna get back into the full swing of it, try to get back to 2 videos a week and stepping my game up and bringing you guys some cool content. So stay tuned for that. Anyway, guys, until next time, I will see you all next time. I'm Rusty. Until next time, Bored Cyborg is out, and I'm gonna roll and hurt myself. See ya.